Customers are worried about quality and not quantity. They are professional. Today I am talking about SOC report, Service Organization Control Report. We know there are mainly three categories of SOC report, SOC 1, SOC 2 and SOC 3. SOC report are independently third party audit report. In this discussion, I am trying to show the basic difference between SOC 1, SOC 2 and SOC 3. Also, trying to show you some sample question on SOC 1, SOC 2 and SOC 3, which is so much important for different types of exam like CISA, CISOM or CISSP. Let's go for detailed discussion. The basis of SOC is based on how companies secure customer data and how efficiently this control are operating. SOC 1, also known as SSAE number 16, is the compliance issued by Auditing Standard Board of American Institute of Certified Public Accountants. It said, check on companies' internal control over financial reporting. So, financial reporting is the main key point for SOC 1. SOC 2, compliance is inclined to the overview of the security service organization's systems. It focuses on how figure out it the design of control meets the benchmark of ICTA Trust Service Principles of Cybersecurity. So, CIA is the main key point for SOC 2. SOC 3 report covers the same testing procedure as SOC 2 report, but it omits the detailed test result and is intended for general public distribution. Ultimately, SOC aims is to evaluate an organization's hosted cybersecurity system and the data stored by the company or processed in reference to security, process, availability, integrity, confidentiality, or privacy. The professional. Now, we have seen some basic difference between the SOC 1, SOC 2, and SOC 3. Actually, SOC 1 reports on internal control over financial reporting. Most of the users are user auditors and controller office. SOC 2 reports on security, confidentiality, processing, integrity, availability, or privacy control. User of SOC 2 are management, regulators, and others. SOC 2 can be shared under non-disclosure agreement. SOC 3 is same as SOC 2. Here security, confidentiality, processing integrity, availability or privacy control are the reporting subject and most of the user are public, general public, so publicly available to anyone. There are two types for SOC 1 and SOC 2. Actually, SOC 3 has no types. So, type 1 is discuss about design of control. That's mean point in time. Actually, it reports is as of a specific date, not a period of time, specific date, not a range, specific date. And type 2 is talking about effectiveness of control, period of time. The report covers a point of time. And the time is minimum 6 months. Now we see some basic question on SOC. Our first question, a service organization is providing accounting service. Which of the following types of report would be best in order to provide trust and assurance in the quality of their service? So, we have to find out the main key point. Here, the main key point is accounting service. So, when talking about financial statement or investment or book of account, custodial service, payroll processing or accounting service, it's talking about financial system. So, according our previous discussion, according our previous table, the correct answer is A, SOC 1. Our second question, which of the following service organization control reports types should an organization request if they require a period of time? Report covering security and availability for a particular system. So here the main keyword, security and availability. So when talking about security, availability, this means cyber security or IT, it's talking about type 2. And when we see that period of time, so ultimately it is talking about type 2. So our correct answer is D, SOC 2, type 2. Our third question, which SOC report should be shared with the general public? So we share the data for general public. Actually, SOC 3 is the only SOC report that should be shared with the general public. So here keyword is general public. So ultimately the right answer is SOC 3. And here one tricky point, that there have no SOC 3 have no type. So here type 1 is omitted. So ultimately correct answer is D. Question number 4. Which of the following SOC report types are based on a single point in time? So here the main keyword is single point in time. So we see that there are two types, type 1, type 2. Type 1 is about single point in time and type 2 is about period of time. So the correct answer is A, type 1. Question number 5. Which of the following SOC report types are based on period of time? So definitely period of time, that's mean we are talking about minimum 6 month length duration. So the correct answer will be B, type 2. Question number 6. Which of the following SOC report would be produced for management of a company who process and stores customer data? So here mainly two concern, two key point. Number one, management, and number two, customer data. So management show SOC 2 report. Customer data, that means it is talking about privacy. We have to maintain the privacy for customer data. So CIA, that means cyber security or IT or security related topics is here. So the correct answer is B, SOC 2. Our last question, an organization prepares to migrate their data to a infrastructure as a service provider. As part of their third party due diligence, they want to understand the effectiveness of the provider security, availability and integrity control. Which SOC report would provide them with the most detail? So here the main keyword are security, availability and integrity control. It's talking about cyber security, IT. So the correct answer will be B. Thank you for watching.